The Greece and Turkey country bowls are about to be gone forever. You'll never be able to get these nations again. To put in your order before it's too late, head over to makeship.com. It's always one of the top links in the descriptions of my videos. As you can see, the countdown before they get sent to the Shadow Realm forever is ticking down fast. What are those? Yeah, I'm just not gonna pronounce this because I know I'll say that wrong. It's a traditional Serbian sausage. And I have yogurt, says Bulgaria. Meanwhile, Greece with this, again, I don't want to butcher this word, of original Greek dessert, as all three of these countries stand with traditional cuisine. Wow, that's so cool. I wish I also had awesome cuisine. How did you come up with these? Well, the answer is short, really.
Strunk Balkan culture.
Oh, this is gonna be controversial. Well, let the war in the comment section begin. This shows Bulgaria, Greece, and Serbia stealing Ottoman slash Turkish food while they're sleeping. I've heard this before, I have to admit. This just reminds me of how often you do see cuisine taken from other cultures, but then there's always a new spin on it. Like, I'm thinking about America's take on Mexican food. Even though I do like Taco Bell, it's not really the same. Or even like American Italian food as well. Every country loves to throw their own twists on things, for better or for worse. The year is 1913. Right before World War I. Hello, my buddy, says Russia to the Ottomans. What do you want again? I want you to give land to my friends. Which friends? The Balkan League, of course. Hello, says Greece. Damn it, responds the Ottomans. And so begins what some people call the prequel to World War I. Chaos broke out in this part of the world, which, keep in mind, Serbia being involved in that. Not too long after, another Serbian would kill the Archduke, leading to all the chaos that was the Great War. It's one of those sequels that are not often talked about, but it really gives a lot of good background information. There was also one Balkan War, but they also decided to have a second as well. Oh look, it's the Soviet Union overlooking their former territories. We got the three Baltic countries, Belarus drinking some sort of substance, Moldova with their Transnistria growth. Don't you sometimes wish of revive and taking back your empire, asks the Soviet Union to. Wait, is that Yugoslavia? Yeah, I have a hunch they kinda wouldn't agree. Serbs, Croatians, and Bosnians literally about to stab each other. Meanwhile, North Macedonia rooting on Serbia, and Montenegro drinking something. Slovenia is above all that, though. I feel like I agree with the overall themes of this post here. I think there is a bit more tranquility from the Soviet Union territory, kinda. At least compared to the former Yugoslavian territory. It's kinda like the war never ended over there. Why are the no-no Germans in heaven, though? Remember, another way to look at this is the overall desire to bring back the Soviet Union from these countries, versus the overall desire to bring back Yugoslavia from these countries. Maybe only the Serbians want that. We all can enter dreams and wishes, Vlad. It's 2003 and we have a bunch of countries designing the new F-35 planes. Triangle Poor, says America to Singapore. You're approved to join our F-35 stealth fighter program as a partner. How many would you like to buy? Meanwhile, Singapore thinking about Malaysia and Indonesia asking, you want to attack us? I'm just going to join to learn a little. Not buying. Here's the membership fees. Cut to 17 years later. Oh look, it's actually here in real life. Although it might have had some problems. Triangle Poor. Our F-35 problems are finally fixed and ready. Are you still interested in buying? Singapore now thinking about, hey, thanks, Korea Ball, for partnering with me to make stealth fighter KF-21. Shut up and take my money. All right, I think America's cool with that. This is the nation of Singapore not biting fighter jets until their neighbors have bought some fighter jets first. Indonesia accidentally started an arms race in the region. Oof. Remember that the nation of Singapore is quite literally a city-state. It is just this very small star. Meanwhile, they are surrounded by Malaysia and Indonesia in the south. So I guess it's a good thing for them that they decided to join this organization in 2003, especially since Indonesia has joined their own organization more recently. Now they're just buying all the planes. Gotta always make sure you had a big enough military, I suppose. Ugh, says Iran. I'm tired of the Middle East. Only war, conflicts, and suffer. Jeez, just look at all that chaos. Time to visit Europa for once. This way to the Balkans. Macedonia! Iran, are you okay? Please do not invade. Please do not invade. Please do not invade. Cut to Iran's Vietnam flashback, except this wasn't flashbacks to Vietnam. This was flashbacks to the great Macedonian Empire that happened over 2,000 years ago, where Persia slash Iran was just completely occupied for a time there. I can see why they would be still a little bit afraid. Alexander the Great's empire was certainly no joke. Welcome aboard, soldier. Oh, this is the USA ball talking to a Swedish ball as they now leave forever the former convention of EU countries, not
in NATO.
Not gonna lie, I didn't think he'd get in before us, says Ireland. I'm going to assume there's a very tiny Malta ball just hidden behind Cyprus here. This tiny Mediterranean island is often forgot, but it's fine. Or maybe they're just like the size of an atom in the country ball universe. So as I've mentioned before, Sweden has now just become the next new member of the NATO alliance. So far, Austria, Cyprus, and Ireland have yet to join. But since they got Sweden, I feel like anything is possible. Remember that Sweden has, for the most part, been a pretty neutral nation for the last couple centuries. They haven't fought a single war since 1814. They weren't involved in World War I or World War II at all. Although, to be fair, they were kind of just really lucky the no-no Germans never declared on Sweden during WW2, because they did on literally almost all their other Nordic brothers. Man, oh man, who's gonna be next? Ate his food, says these two Palestinian balls. Let's see what America gave him. Wait a minute. All right, this might not exactly be what they were expecting. I mean, you can kind of call this food. Twinkies, Monster Energy drinks, Red Bull, Doritos, Mountain Dew. This is just gamer fuel. Maybe they were confused. Is that why they also got a copy of Madden Football? Well, I don't know what else we expected from America. And to give him a game on top of all that that just asks for so much microtransactions, it's just so insulting. Frick yeah, Saudi Arabia just gave us a free all-inclusive trip. Yeah, but he's still an evil despot, responds Canada. You're tripping, dog. He's one of the cool guys around here. Besides, he's slowly trying to fix himself. You just like him because he's rich. Seriously, dude, I'm telling you, he's chill. He doesn't even try to hide the fact that he's bad. He's such a bad, Hey guys, is my new tower you is like, yes? Well, I think it's cool. Meanwhile, Canada is not amused. The US just bending over backwards to justify their friendship with Saudi Arabia, even though they might possibly build the Eye of Sauron one day. I actually don't think so, but I wouldn't be surprised if they just rolled it out. Let's just hope they don't start crafting any powerful rings while they're at it. Is Sauron leading this nation here in the Middle East? It's only to protect ethnic Russian minority against Moldavian oppression. It's only to protect ethnic Russian minority against Georgian oppression. It's only to protect ethnic Russian minority against more Georgian oppression. It's only to protect Russian minority against oppression. It's only to protect ethnic Russian minority against more oppression. It's only to protect ethnic Russian against no-no oppression in Ukraine. Russia's still big. Oh my goodness. Why is you always protect Russian minority in other countries when there's so much oppressed Russian majority inside Russia? Let's see how he answers this one. It's only to protect Russian against... Should have predicted that, honestly. I guess this has been their stance on things for a minute here. Interesting way to go about it. There's definitely probably more examples they could have used for this comic, but then it would have just gone on for too long. It's 1523 AD. Blah, I feel sick. Frick you all. From now today to all future, I work by myself. Alone. Well, okay then. 1721. Give Baltics back. I still don't want anyone's freaking help. 1941. Give Carlea back. I still don't want anyone's help. 2024. Give Europe back. maybe for old time's sake, we should ask for help.
Sure.
Oh, and here are all the Nordic countries now joining NATO. Kind of a brief history on the Nordic countries and how they split up and I guess how they recently came together. Remember, historically, there was a period of time where they were united. This was known as the Kalmar Union in the 1300s. It really was all the Nordic countries, including Greenland, Finland, all of Scandinavia, of course, parts of northern Germany nowadays, Faroe Islands and Iceland even. That only lasted for about 125 years, though. It exploded, and they would kind of take each other over, but they wouldn't be that united again until they had a much more common enemy. That common enemy, I guess, being Russia, which makes sense. Now they've kind of reformed the Kalmar Union just within NATO. That's kind of interesting. I never saw it before like that until right now. All right, my little bros. Now that you're a part of Team Freedom, you gotta look the part. Aw, they're giving them shades. Your future is bright, so keep them shades on at all times. I look cool as fuck. Damn, I'm proud to have you boys. Don't forget to grab a circus peanut on your way out to hurl at China. Doink. You called my Discord just for this? 2 points, responds Singapore. Here's Vietnam, Singapore, and the Philippines doing exactly as the USA asks. Well, I guess through Discord, but yeah, they're honorary shade wearing balls now. Sounds like an interesting phrase. I guess Singapore's a triangle. Is Team Freedom basically like the Avengers now? Well, 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 if it isn't my favorite son, we've been making great progress on our nuclear program. Ripper, Dad, to what do I owe the pleasure? Oh, it's just your old man needs a favor. Cut to 2 seconds later. What favor? Huh, I wonder. Apparently the British tested their first nuclear bomb ever. ever in Australia. That's nice. They became the third nuclear power nation in 1952, which was only 3 years after the Soviet Union got their first nuke. They weren't too far behind. What a beautiful thing a dad could ask to do to his son. Drop another son on his son. Be sure to check that link in the description down below to makeshift.com to pick these up before they're gone forever. And big thanks to my patrons. Kansas was mentioned.
Douche Baggins.
A fat Norwalk.
Amateur archaeology.
The beautiful Megan
Edward
Frederick
Hadley.
Headland.
Inquisitor
Darius.
John
Gambino
is best.
Luxembourg.
Rye the
pie.
I love the Mexican 760.
And Zany Boy.